All right, let's talk about health. That's what's coming up right now. There could be metal in some of the things that you eat, and it's not there by accident, folks. New research finds that more and more manufacturers are adding tiny nano-sized particles of titanium to foods like yogurt and soy milk as well.
Joining us, Dr. Carrie Peterson from Lenox Hill Hospital. Thank you for coming in.
Yeah. Thanks for having me.
Good.
Titanium in food to enhance color. What do you think?
Well, I never knew about this either, but there's apparently there are these things called nanoparticles. They're teeny tiny. They're invisible to the naked eye. Mm. And there's several different kinds. Titanium dioxide is one. Silver is another. Clay is another. Used for different purposes to add to food. Titanium dioxide is used to make the whites of food whiter, which is why it's in dairy and in soy milk and even in things like ranch dressing. And silver is used as an antimicrobial, so it's even put in socks to repel germs, but it's sprayed on fruits as well. And the concern is, can it get into the fruit? And are we ingesting it? And then things like clay are put in packaging to prevent air and moisture from getting into the products. So again, is the clay getting into what we're ingesting?
So here you're saying, you know, I didn't know this. I'm surprised. I'm shocked. And so what does the FDA say about all of this?
Well, the FDA actually allows 1% titanium dioxide in food as long as it's very, very pure. But in 2012, they released a statement saying we still need to investigate this further. And they did have concerns. In particular, they were addressing bioavailability. But the jury really is still out. We don't know how safe they are yet. This is a new technology.
It's very upsetting. So we don't know how safe it is yet. So
yet.
At this point, we can just continue on eating the things that we eat and ignoring it?
Well, if you are concerned about whether you're ingesting it, you can do things like buy organically because they're less likely to have the nanotechnology, buy local food because food that has to be transported long distances is more likely to be sprayed with things like the silver. So you can try to work around it. And there are lists online of what foods contain them.
Okay, let's give that a little rest right now, speaking of that.
Also in the headlines today, unlocking the secrets of sleep, researchers are working to find out why some people are genetically wired to get through the day in less than 6 hours and why some other people need a lot more sleep than that.
Interesting study.
And whether people are night owls or morning larks.
Yeah.
It's this husband-wife team, and they're trying to unravel secrets of sleep. Mm-hmm. And they're trying to understand why are some people morning birds and other people are night owls.
So what they find out?
They actually are still investigating it. What they're looking for is genetic mutations. What their goal is to create a drug that alters our circadian rhythm, which is our body's internal clock. And if we can alter that rhythm, we can utilize it for people who are night shift workers or for people with jet lag. So they're connecting DNA samples from morning birds and from people that don't need a lot of sleep. And they're looking at what common mutations are there between them. And they've discovered a few. And for morning birds, they're actually now using drug therapy under investigation in experimental stages to see, can we fix or change the circadian rhythms of people?
So what kind of traits, for example, do people have that don't need as much sleep?
Well, the short sleepers, these are short sleepers. Right. They need less than 6 hours. They were found in interviews to be more energetic, more optimistic, and have higher thresholds for pain. One woman even said, I don't need Novocaine at the dentist.
Wow.
Very interesting.
For those with less sleep.
Who need less sleep,
Wow, you'd almost think it would be the other way around.
I know. It was. You would think they'd have less energy, but no, the opposite.
Yeah, interesting.
Yeah, so on that note, let's talk about advantages to being an early riser or a night owl.
Well, early risers tend to be more productive because it's lighter. When you wake up, you can get more done. And what they found is night shift workers, people who work nights and sleep during the day, they are at higher risk of getting cancer, obesity, and metabolic syndrome. So there are health risks involved with staying up all night.
So in other words, you just said that the advantages goes to the early riser.
Yes. The morning lark and the early riser.
Yeah, the night owl is it a disadvantage?
It's not as advantageous, no.
Everybody's smiling around
you. Early
Look
bird
at you, Nick.
Catches the worm.
That's it.
Get a good night's rest, Carrie.
I'm going to try to go to bed early tonight.
Good for you. Okay, what do you say there, Nick?
Yeah, well,